Hi, my name is Antoine Deggs. I'm an equity derivative strategist at BNP Paribas. Why dividend futures? Really, that depends on the investor. I think when trading dividend futures, it's essential to understand that when we are trading the short end of the curve or the long end of the curve, we are kind of not trading the same product. Investors trading the short end of the curve will take a directional exposure based on their fundamental expectation because the short end of the curve is based on where you expect the dividend to realize compared to a market price, and then you will take a directional exposure based on that analysis. The long end of the curve, in another way, is rather based on macroeconomic expectations. You will have a much higher beta, market beta, on long-term dividends than on short-term dividends, based on the fact that you have much more uncertainty on the expected earnings and expected dividends on long-term maturities. And then the long-term dividend will tend to behave more as high beta to the underlying index. The strategy on long-term maturities, which is the most discounted part of the curve, is usually traded by investors with a less sensitivity to mark-to-market, pension funds, or investors that will look at a beta replacement or dividend yield investments. So basically, why to trade dividend futures? It can be based on macroeconomic expectation with a high sensitivity to long-term dividend yield to inflation expectation, or it can be based just on the fundamental expectation, earning expectations, dividend policy expectation, based on bottom-up analysis and short-term positioning and carry positioning on the short end of the curve. So your stock dividend curve, I've been steepening a lot since July 2016, coming from deeply backward sloping to slightly backward sloping. The market is still pricing a negative implied dividend growth from the 2018 maturity till the 2026 maturity, but the implied dividend risk premium has reduced a lot compared to what we used to see in previous years. This is coming from two different reasons. On the long end of the curve, we have a high sensitivity of long-term dividend yield compared to inflation expectation. So with the rebound of inflation expectations in H2 2016, we had a rise in long-term implied dividend yield. On the short end of the curve, we also had a reduction of risk premium. This has come from the fact that while we used to look at the downside risk in our base case scenario, what dividend could be cut for any company like Santander, Telefonica, for instance. Now we are looking at upside risk potential. With positive earning revision, we could have also in our base case scenario positive dividend revisions. But our view is that we had an inflation in the payout ratio of the index post-2011. Payout ratio of the Euro Stoxx 50 index have rise from 47-50% to above 50%, and we expect now a normalization of that payout ratio in the next 2 years before we can see a full potential to have an increase in dividend from the Euro Stoxx dividend companies. The result is, despite the fact that we recognize that there is an upside risk on earnings, we expect to have limited impact in our base case estimates on dividends. Thus, our view currently is that the dividend risk premium on the short end of the curve is quite low. We are not comfortable in taking carry position on the short end of the curve, and we prefer defensive strategy, relative value strategies, while we still favor to position on longer maturities, to get a better carry expected annualized return, besides the fact that there is a higher beta on the long end of the curve. There was a strong growth in the single stock dividend future market as there were a lot of sector or single stock specific stories over the last few months. This has been driving the need to hedge from some actors with option position on the index or even on single stock names. And it has been driving also flows from investors taking a directional view on these sectors or these specific single names as Santander, as Telefonica, as a few names like this. On the index side, as I was saying, the risk premium has diminished a lot. So we had much lower inflows that we used to see the previous years. And when we had the reduction of open interest coming from the future 2016 coming at maturity, now the open interest is not growing as fast as it used to grow the previous years because of this reduction of appetite to take risk of short-term dividends.